Of 29 degrees. Chance of showers tomorrow afternoon. The back into sunshine for Wednesday. But it sounds like a fantastic week. It's 20 right now. Fargo's in the CJ 80 newsroom.
In Andrew, a command post remains in place in Anjou this morning. Police are probing an apparent murder-suicide. A 10-month-old baby boy's life taken away allegedly by his own father. There's support and a rally today for Longueuil's mayor, all in connection with a language flap in that South Shore city. And UPAC officials get go-ahead from Panamanian people to confirm that Arthur Porter is really, indeed, dead. We'll have details on those stories coming up on your 8:30 news.
All right, thank you. Tommy State coming up after 8:30. And up next, nutritionist Leslie Buck.
The Andrew Carter Morning Show, brought to you by...
No time to shop around for your new mattress? No problem. Your new mattress is just a phone call or a click away at matabana.ca.
Can't miss radio, the Aaron Rand Show.
I'm along with Dr. Carol Sikora, close friend and doctor to Arthur Porter. Dr. Sikora, I'm wondering, a lot of people, including the Quebec Crown, thinking that Arthur Porter may not actually be dead. What do you believe?
I don't agree, but I think the most couple of pictures of me on the beach and the actual pictures in the Colorado today, it is ridiculous. I'm not going to show you he's definitely dead, but it's just kind of an upstairs this morning doing this sort of thing.
Those trials, they found that losing
losing weight and exercising 30 minutes a day, well, 30 minutes five times a week, reduce the risk of prediabetes progressing to type 2 diabetes by 60%. And the lifestyle intervention group, the group who exercised, who lost a little bit of weight, they did better than the group getting metformin, which is a drug used to prevent type 2 diabetes.
Okay, are there fruit foods that can help prevent?
There are. And